Oh boy, time for another episode of Maybe I'm Rambling More Internet Paranoia. U.S. judge throws out Facebook antitrust lawsuits. A U.S. federal court has dismissed two separate antitrust lawsuits filed against Facebook. Judge James Boasberg ruled that the Federal Trade Commission, FTC's antitrust complaint against the social networking giant was too vague. Spying is too vague? Really? Another separate anti-competition lawsuit filed by a coalition of states was thrown out because the alleged violations occurred too long ago. Obnoxious and absurd. Facebook's shares jumped 4.2% to $355.64 on the news. Of course it does. This resulted in the social networking giant's market value rising above $1 trillion. £720 billion. For the first time ever. In the U.S. District Court for the District of Columbia ruling, Judge Boasberg wrote that the FTC's complaint was legally insufficient and had to be dismissed because the FTC had failed to plead enough facts to back up its claim that Facebook was stifling competition. The FTC's lawsuit had requested that the technology giant, which also owns Instagram and WhatsApp, be broken up. The FTC's complaint says almost nothing concrete on the key question of how much power Facebook actually had, and still has, in a properly defined antitrust product market, wrote Judge Boasberg. Monopolies are bad for business. When will people understand that? It is almost as if the agency expects the court to simply nod to the conventional wisdom that Facebook is a monopolist. It is you got ants for brains if you trust Facebook. While this is a setback for the FTC that some analysts say could have repercussions for the future of anti-competition law in the US, once again monopolies are the bane of free market. Everyone lose with it. The watchdog can refile the charges and has until the 28th of July to do so, doing nothing over the last half decade. Separately, Judge Boasberg also dismissed an anti-competition lawsuit brought by a coalition of 45 U.S. states, together with the FTC. This lawsuit had also sought to force Facebook to divest Instagram and WhatsApp. It related to Facebook's acquisition of the two apps in 2012 and 2014, in March. Facebook petitioned the federal court in the U.S. to dismiss them, describing the FTC complaint as nonsensical. Of course it is, your data belongs to everyone, got it. The firm said the FTC's case ignores the reality of the dynamic, intensely competitive high-tech industry in which Facebook operates. What competition? Who's really competing with in his ruling on this case? Judge Boasberg said that the states did not provide a reasonable justification for why they had waited between 6 to 8 years to decide to sue Facebook, an argument the social networking giant previously made. That may be true, but still, what if they didn't have the funds or was blackmailed by Facebook itself? He added that the states had failed to provide a factual dispute and only gave a half-hearted contention that Facebook was not prejudiced but rather benefited from the states not filing sooner, since it has been and remains a very profitable company. Of course selling people's personal data is profitable. Ultimately this antitrust action is premised on public high-profile conduct, nearly all of which occurred over 6 years ago, before the launch of the Apple Watch or Alexa or Periscope, when Kevin Durant still played for the Oklahoma City Thunder, and when Ebola was the virus dominating headlines, wrote Judge Boasberg. He added that the state's allegations made it clear that the lawsuit could easily have been filed between 2012 and 2014. The system of antitrust enforcement that Congress has established does not exempt plaintiffs here from the consequences of their choice to do nothing over the last half decade. Yeah man, they took too long, man, they could be broke, but they took too long.